outline of protein sequence. The primary structure comprises the identification of constituent amino acids with regard to their quality, quantity and sequence in a protein structure. A pure sample of a protein or polypeptide is essential for the determination of primary structure, which involves three stages. One is determination of amino acid composition. Second, degradation of protein or polypeptide into smaller fragments. Third one is determination of amino acid sequence. The first step, determination of amino acid composition in a protein. The protein or polypeptide is completely hydrolyzed to liberate the amino acids, which are quantitatively estimated. The hydrolysis may be carried out either by acid or alkali treatment or by enzyme hydrolysis. Treatment with enzymes, however, results in smaller peptides rather than amino acids. Proteinase is a mixture of non-specific proteolytic enzymes that causes complete hydrolysis of proteins. Separation and estimation of amino acids. The mixture of amino acids liberated by protein hydrolysis can be determined by chromatographic techniques. The reader must refer for the separation and quantitative determination of amino acids. Knowledge on primary structure of proteins will be incomplete without the thorough understanding of chromatography. The next stage is degradation of protein into smaller fragments. Protein is a larger molecule which is sometimes composed of individual polypeptide chains. Separation of polypeptides is essential before degradation. Step 1. Liberation of polypeptides. Treatment with urea or guanidine hydrochloride disturbs the non-covalent bonds and dissociates the protein into polypeptide units for cleaving the disulfide linkages between the polypeptide units. Treatment with formic acid is necessary. Next step is number of polypeptides. The number of polypeptide chains can be identified by treatment of protein with diacyl chloride. It specifically binds with N-terminal amino acids to form diacyl polypeptides, which on hydrolysis yield N-terminal diacyl amino acid. The number of diacyl amino acids produced is equal to the number of polypeptide chains in the protein. The next stage is breakdown of polypeptides into fragments. Polypeptides are degraded into smaller peptides by enzymatic or chemical method. In enzymatic method, the proteolytic enzymes such as trypsin, chymotrypsin, pepsin and elastase exhibit specificity in cleaving the peptide bonds. Among these enzymes, trypsin is most commonly used. It hydrolyzes the peptide bonds containing lysine or arginine on the carbonyl side of peptide linkage. In chemical cleavage, cyanogen bromide is commonly used to split polypeptides into smaller fragments. The cyanogen bromide specifically split peptide bonds, the carbonyl sites of which is contributed by an amino acid methionine. The third step is determination of amino acid sequence. The polypeptides or their smaller fragments are covalently utilized for the determination of sequence of amino acids. This is done in a stepwise manner to finally build up the order of amino acids in a protein. Certain reagents are employed for the sequence of determination. The one is Sanger's reagent. The Sanger used 1-fluoro-2,4-dinitrobenzene, that is FDNB, to determine insulin structure. FDNB specifically binds with N-terminal amino acid to form a dinitrophenyl derivative of peptide, that is DNB. This on hydrolysis yield DNB amino acid, that is N-terminal, and free amino acid from the rest of the peptide chain. DNB amino acid can be identified by chromatography. Sanger's reagent has limited use since the peptide chain is hydrolyzed to amino acids. The next one is Edman's reagent. The phenyl isothiocyanate is the Edman's reagent. It reacts with the N-terminal amino acid of polypeptide to form phenyl thiocarbamyl derivative. On treatment with the mild acid, phenyl thioiodation, that is PTH amino acid, a cyclic compound, is liberated. This can be identified by chromatography. Advanced reagent has an advantage since the peptide can be sequentially degraded, liberating N-terminal amino acids one after another, which can be identified. This is due to the fact that the peptide as a whole is not hydrolyzed, but only releases PTH amino acid. Next is sequencer. This is an automatic machine to determine the amino acid sequence in a polypeptide with around 100 residues. It is based on the principles of advanced reagent degradation. Amino acids are determined sequentially from N-terminal end. The PTH amino acid liberated is identified by high performance liquid chromatography, that is HPLC. Sequencer takes about 2 hours to determine each amino acids. Overlapping peptides. In the determination of primary structure of proteins, several methods, that is enzymatic or chemical or semi-quantitative method, are simultaneously employed. This results in the formation of overlapping peptides. This is due to the specific action of different agents on different sites in the polypeptide. Overlapping peptides are very useful in determining the amino acid sequence. Next one is reverse sequencing technique. It is the genetic material, it is chemically DNA, which is ultimately determines the sequence of amino acids in the polypeptide chains. By analyzing the nucleotide sequence of DNA that codes for protein, it is possible to translate the nucleotide sequence into amino acid sequence. This technique, however, fails to identify the disulfide bonds and changes that occur in the amino acids after the protein is synthesized, that is post-translational modifications. Next is automated sequencing. Using the advanced degradation technique, sequencing can be completed within a few hours by automatic sequencer and study of higher levels of protein structures. The higher levels of protein structures may be studied by techniques using X-ray diffraction, ultraviolet spectroscopy, optical rotatory dye prism, circular dichromism, nuclear magnetic resonance, that is NMR. The NMR spectroscopy measures the absorbance of radio frequency of atomic nuclei by studying the frequency at which the particular nucleus absorbs energy. We could get an idea of the functional groups available in the molecule. Two-dimensional NMR permits the three-dimensional representation of the protein in a solution. It also helps to study the alteration in the conformation of a protein during binding with another ligand. A beam of X-ray is diffracted by the electrons around each atom, and the intensity of diffracted beam is detected by the photographic plate or collected by an electronic device. This X-ray diffraction study is possible only on crystallized proteins. Slice to protein.